A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 21st October, on the front page you have Day of Reckoning. So this is regarding legislative assembly elections which are going to take place in Maharashtra and Haryana. So, and bipolls are also held in some states listed below. So here you can see. Then this is three POK terror camps destroyed, army chief. So four launch pads targeted Tangdhar and Kiran sectors in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir, you can see. So across the LOC, army hit terrorist launch pads with heavy artillery as such. So Pakistan also opened heavy firing on civilians and posed that. This is what Indian side says, that we targeted these terrorist launch pads. So, six Pakistani soldiers were killed in the firing. And it is said each launch pad had 15 to 20 terrorists waiting to infiltrate. Then below you have, government should reverse cuts on corporate taxes, Abhijit Banerjee. So, this is Nobel Prize winner Abhijit Banerjee. He won the Nobel Prize in economics. So he is saying that the corporate tax rate cuts which were announced by the government should be considered reversing. So he also says that the PM Kisan scheme should be expanded to include non-farmers as such. So these are two suggestions which have been given by 2019 Nobel Prize winner Abhijit Banerjee. So he said, I would not have cut the corporate taxes. Reversing now may be too costly, but it's something to consider because that's a huge burden on the fiscal, as such, on the finance. And that money would have been better spent by giving more through PM Kisan and raising the NREGA wages. Those are the kind of things that will get money in the hands of those who really will spend it. So that is this. So if you cut corporate tax, corporates are not going to spend that money. It's not going to come in the economy. They are already spending. There's no extra income which you earn. It will not be spent. It will be saved or such. But if you give money in the hands of the poor, they will actually spend them. So this is his suggestion. Then this is two panels set up to revamp British era IPC. So Home Minister is all set to overhaul the Indian Penal Code designed by the British. So senior government official said that rebooting the code introduced by the government in 1860 was necessary as it is primarily based on the spirit of master and servant. So for that, two panels will be established. So this is what Home Minister Amit Shah has announced. And this is anthrax scare at Assam's Pobitra sanctuary after death of two buffaloes. So veterinarians have confirmed anthrax as the cause of death of two Asiatic water buffaloes in central Assam's Pobitra wildlife sanctuary. So it has highest concentration of one-horned rhinos in the world. Pobitra wildlife sanctuary means highest density. And your anthrax as a cause of death has resulted in concerns, because anthrax, this is a bacteria that can be fatal for humans also who come in contact with the infected animals. Then on page 2 you have IOE tag will lead to privatization in DU. So this is regarding Delhi University. So in September 2019, you should know that Delhi University was among 5 public universities identified under Ministry of Human Resource Development's Institute of Eminence scheme. So benefits of being under institutes of eminence include increased autonomy in different aspects of the university's functioning, and also they would get additional 1000 crore in funding. So here you can see that after this, Delhi University now plans to set up parallel centers which will be outside the purview of its statutory bodies, and this it says would pave the way for increased privatization and dismantling of public funded university. So this is how the additional money which would be provided would be set would be used. It would set up 9 new centers in different areas of focus. On page 3 you have No Diwali boom for green crackers. So it has said lack of awareness among buyers, shortage of supply, lack of variety and implementation challenges have dampened the sale of environmentally friendly firecrackers, the green crackers. The Supreme Court had also, you should remember, announced that green crackers should be used across the country. NERI, National Environmental Engineering Research Institute, said its labs had been able to make trial samples which had been approved by PESO2, the authority which looks into this, that is Petroleum and Explosive Safety Organization. So these green crackers, they are in the market and have a unique logo and a unique QR code too, to trace their origin. But then their quantity as such and variety as such is not sufficient. So the implementation issues have cropped up. So here you can see strict guidelines had been given by Supreme Court on green firecrackers. So there is significant fall in applications for temporary licenses for firecrackers and explosives since then. But green crackers have not completely taken the market yet. On page 5 you have NTCA red flags MP government's move. So this is regarding National Tiger Conservation Authority, which has red flagged the Madhya Pradesh government's move to increase tourism activities inside the state's tiger reserves in violation of the existing guidelines, and has asked Madhya Pradesh government to take corrective steps. So a complaint was filed that the state government has increased the tourism carrying capacity of the reserves by allowing in more number of vehicles carrying visitors. So, you know, it is said this is done without making necessary changes in tiger conservation and ecotourism plans. It is said that India has 2,967 tigers, with 526 of them in Madhya Pradesh alone, which is highest in the country. So there are 6 tiger reserves in Madhya Pradesh which are listed out. So you should know about them. Kanha, Bandhavgarh, Panna, Satpura, Sanjay Dubri and Pinch. On page 9, you have cyber police stations in Tamil Nadu soon. So the government, as such, the state government has sanctioned 28.97 crores for setting up stations and labs in Tamil Nadu. These will be dedicated cyber stations and labs equipped with tools to retrieve data, including deleted ones from mobile phones, SIM cards, laptops and hard disks, even softwares for hacking and surveillance of computing systems. And this is railway board to be trimmed by 25%, say sources. So director level officials will be moved to zonal railways and the railway board would be trimmed. So this is the decision which has been taken as such to enhance efficiency. Then below you have liver transplant registry off to a good start. So this is first of its kind in India. Voluntary liver transplant registry, which has been started on 15th August, and it has picked up pace now. In a span of little over 2 months, it has received data of 74 transplants carried out by 11 hospitals across 6 states. So this was initiated by Liver Transplantation Society of India, a registry aimed at collating national data of procedures and the outcomes. It is said nearly 2,000 liver transplants are carried out in India annually, which is highest in the world, yet there is no India-specific data. Then below you have former rebels find new start among goats. So this is regarding former extremists in Assam. So they are farming reform in a revenue-sharing arrangement. So what they're doing is Ministry of Home Affairs has been implementing this rehabilitation scheme for surrendered extremists in the Northeast since 1998. So package includes one-time grant, monthly stipend and incentives for depositing weapons. So this scheme makes them self-reliant, and in Assam, it also helps the government check encroachment. So here you can see what has been done in Assam. So the goat farm has been set up with, and here it is managed by 28 ex-militants who are among 1,800 trained in various skills under the Swavlamban project by the Assam Police Special Branch. On the editorial page, the first editorial is charging Chidambaram. So this is regarding after CBI charge sheet, questions are now raised on need to arrest in cases turning on documentary proof. So Mr. Chidambaram and his son, they were arrested. So of course this arrest had been controversial. So whether there was a need to arrest or not, so questioning that is what this editorial does. And second editorial, it's a deal. So this is regarding the deal which has been clinched between Britain and EU. So Britain might avoid a no-deal Brexit, but it will have to grapple with the costs of leaving European Union, is what this editorial says. We had seen how the British Parliament has sought more time. It wants to extend the October 31 deadline for Brexit. It wants more time to study the deal as such. The lead article, after Mamallapuram, the reality of asymmetry. So it says, if India does not wish to live in China-dominated global order, it must make difficult choices now. So China is a dominant partner, is evident. You know, India-China plus relations which have been extended, which has been spoken of even for Afghanistan, Nepal, and also Pakistan. So that makes China a dominant player. So that such aspects are discussed here. And this is a time-tested way to trade away conflict. So trade strengthens peace, and there's need to be a revised strategy, restarting cross-LOC trade. So it's a trade brings in peace, it ends conflict. It's a time-tested formula. But what we have seen is in Jammu Kashmir, what has been done is trade has been stopped. And people were suffering, and now another decision which has been taken is bifurcation of Jammu and Kashmir. But here this article talks of how cross LOC trade should be restarted. Then on op-ed page again, you have a case for abjuring custodial interrogation. So this article also says that this arrest as such violates right against self-incrimination and right to silence and is therefore unconstitutional. Again, in Chidpi Chidambaram case, in which arrest took place, and this is the victory of pluralism. So, resistance to Amit Shah's remarks on Hindi proclaimed the greatness of multilingual culture. So, he had spoken of Hindi to be made into a national language, which had resulted in controversy. Especially from the southern states where they do not want Hindi to be imposed. On page 12, you have SAARC varsity move upsets academics. So, an advertisement seeking application for post of president to SAARC University, that is South Asian University, which is the flagship educational center of SAARC. It is in Delhi. So, this advertisement seeking applications has caused quiet among universities' academics. So, government circular on the recruitment for the next president calls for applications only from Indian candidates. So, this has raised questions about the university adhering to the principles of rotation for the post among SAARC members. So, this is a controversy which has come forth. And here, this is the front page news continuation on two panels which will be set up to revamp British era Indian Penal Code of 1860. On page 13, you have this interview with Nobel Prize winner for economics for 2019, Abhijit Banerjee. He says, I think India could be going through a hard time. He says, there's a lot of stress on our social fabric and it's been there for a while. And economic decline is driving social change too. So, this is important on strategies for revamping the economy as such too. And below you have India-Maldives to take defense ties forward. So, Dornier aircraft will be leased to Maldives by India. So the two leaders met in Delhi. You can see this is Maldives president who is here. So we have various schemes, programs between India and Maldives running, and this lease of Dornier aircraft is also under the broad-based humanitarian assistance and disaster relief exercise between the two nations. So India's coastal radar chain network is there, which under which these aircrafts are being leased. India also gifted the Maldives two advanced light helicopters in 2013, and each was operated by Indian Coast Guard and the Indian Navy. But then a controversy had broken out last year after the previous Maldives government refused to extend the visas to Indian military personnel and asked India to take back the helicopters. So there have been strains in the relations between India and Maldives under the former government. But now it seems that relations are again easy. On international page, you have Rohingya agree to move to Bay of Bengal Island. So, Bangladesh plans to relocate 1 lakh refugees to to which are there in these camps in Cox's Bazar. So thousands of refugees live here. So they have agreed to move to an island in Bay of Bengal. So you should know about this, but it's a dangerous site because in past half a century, powerful cyclones have killed hundreds of thousands of people in the Meghna River estuary, where the island is located. So there are concerns as such too also about relocation to this island. It's a flood prone site. So this is the Bhashanchar Island where relocation is planned. Then on Mondays on economy page you have business page, you have money wise coverage, which is on individual decisions. And the last page has sports news. So that's it. These were the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. There is a little glitch in the website, but it has been worked on. Sunday was a holiday. Today is election day in Maharashtra. But we'll get that back working soon. Sorry for the inconvenience. Thank you.